Yo, Mr. Imob, my name is Rayo, and I've been creating and editing gaming highlight clips for more than 5 years, and as long as I remember, and throughout all this time, I've been using only Nvidia Shadowplay. You might have heard about this, you might have not. The reason I've been using Nvidia Shadowplay isn't because I'm super happy with the software. Actually, within the past year, I've been growing more and more frustrated with Nvidia Shadowplay because I've been having so many problems with it. For example, and this is really important to me, is that Shadowplay doesn't work with some game anti-cheats. For example, Faceit anti-cheat. So whenever I play CSGO with my friends on Faceit, I can't record any of my highlights. And the worst thing is, this could be the case with many other anti-cheats as well, which definitely sucks because I had like millions of highlight clips I wanted to save. I'm level 10 on Faceit, so you can trust me on this.
Lol. I had no idea where it is.
I mean, I would show you the highlights, but I can't because the damn thing doesn't record anything. And that has been just unacceptable to me. But the real issue was that I didn't even know there was anything better available. So I just accepted the fact that I can't clip any of my Counter-Strike clips. Until about a week ago when I was contacted by Lowkey. No, not the guy from the Marvel universe, but a company that recently raised $7 million to help you capture your best gaming highlight moments. And is used by millions of gamers, including some of the top pros in League of Legends or Valorant. At first, I was pretty skeptical, as usual, because so far I've been literally rejecting every single sponsorship opportunity I had. But since I was desperately looking for some other way to capture my CSGO highlight moments, I just decided to give it a try. I mean, if I tried it for a week and I didn't like it, then I could have just pretended I never saw their email, and that's pretty much it. But a week passed by, and now Lowkey is sponsoring this video.
Let's go.
Guys, leave a like for this video because this is my first ever sponsored video on this channel. And also subscribe if you haven't yet. But anyways, the reason I'm doing this sponsored video for them is that this thing is amazing. I'm gonna tell you exactly why from now on I'll be using Lowkey to record all of my gaming highlight clips and why you should as well. If you have ever experienced any issues with any other recording software, or you're just looking for a software where with a single press of a keyboard button you can literally save your best gaming moments and then share it with your friends, then I highly encourage you to try this out. The download link is in the description. Go check it out. As you already heard, the main reason I switched from Nvidia Shadowplay to Lowkey is because I don't have any problems with anti-cheats anymore. But on top of that, when I first downloaded Lowkey, I saw how easy to use it was. It took me literally like 3 minutes to set everything up, and then I could actually forget about the software itself, and it did all the work for me. You only have to set it up once, then you just leave it open while you game and the software does the rest. Once you have saved your clip, then you can instantly share it with your friends. Anyways, enough talking, I'm gonna show you how to set it all up. Alright, so once you have downloaded Lowkey, then just open it up and you can instantly just register really easily with Discord, Apple or your email. Doing it with Discord is probably the easiest option. I'm gonna sign in because I already have a user. And there we go, we are now on our dashboard. This is how the interface looks like. It's really smooth and easy to navigate. So I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger for you, and then you can already see in the down left corner that the software is waiting for a game to start. So it automatically recognizes all the games you're playing, and you can set it to automatically start recording once you're in a game, or you can do it manually here as well. And here we have some quick options for to toggle microphone or to toggle webcam. And while the software has a much more thorough options menu, then here we have a very simplistic and easy to use fast options menu for quick changes for our input devices. For example, here you can add your microphone or even multiple microphones if you want that. And here we can change if we want to record either VODs or just clips. So clips, this is my favorite option because, for example, when I play some FPS games, then whenever I get some really cool highlights that I want to save, then I can just press my F10 on my keyboard. This is what I have it set to. By the way, you can have it on whatever keybind you want, but we're gonna look at this later. Then whenever I get a clip and I press F10, it's gonna save me the last X seconds. The X here means that you can also manually set the amount of time you want it to save. So it's kind of like going back in time and saving the last 120 seconds, so it's saving the last 2 minutes of my gameplay. So it's really important here to understand that when you're choosing to record full-length recordings or VODs, then it's gonna continuously record every game you play and save it on your PC. But when you only record clips, then yes, it's kind of recording everything you're playing, but it doesn't save it on the PC. It only saves it once you press your keybind. I hope it makes sense. If you have never heard about this concept before, then it might be a little bit confusing, I understand, but you're gonna get it soon, don't worry. So this is our quick options menu, but we can also see all settings, of course. And here in the general tab, we can choose where to save my videos. I recommend you choose some folder where you can easily find them if you need them. And also there's a really cool feature that I've never seen before. If your storage space is limited, then you can choose how much storage space the clips are allowed to use. So for example, you choose 25 gigabytes, then once it fills 25 gigabytes of clips, it automatically starts deleting the older clips. I leave it to unlimited because I don't have problems with my disk space, but I think it's a really cool option to have. And the next one is capture. Obviously, if you're using this software to capture your gameplay, then choose game capture, because this also means that it's gonna run probably a little bit more smoother. But as you can see, it says might not work for some games. And this is probably not the issue on their side. It's just that some games might not allow any recording software in the background. So if this doesn't work, then just use display capture, perfectly fine. And also this means you can just capture your desktop if you want to, if you're not using this for games. This option also solves the problem where if in any game you have some problems with anti-cheat or it doesn't let you record for any reason, this will solve it. With display capture, you can still record your gameplay. All right, but for now, game capture it is. The next option is just really beautiful because if you have this turned on, then it starts automatically recording any game you play and you never have to worry about it. All right, the next tab, video and audio. So here is where you can bump up your video quality. So starting with frame rate, 60 FPS is best with gaming clips, of course, but if your computer is not good enough, you can obviously go lower. Wouldn't recommend going lower than 25 FPS, but if you're not doing any gaming stuff and you're just recording your screen, then 30 FPS or even 25 is absolutely fine. Bitrate, well, this is the place where you can play around a little bit depending on how powerful your PC is, of course, but I just like to leave it on 20 because I don't really need extremely high quality clips because I'm not like a movie editor or anything. I mainly use my clips for Instagram, TikTok, sometimes even YouTube, and for these things 20 is more than enough. And on top of that, it also helps me save some storage space. Because the thing is, if you're really looking for that top-notch quality, which by the way, most of you, 99% of you will never need. For example, you go up to 100, then your storage space is gonna get full really quickly. So between 15 and 30 is generally what I recommend, depending on how powerful your PC is. I'm gonna leave it on 20. Resolution is up to you. I don't recommend you go lower than 1080. And even though I have a 2K monitor, I still use 180 resolution for the clips because I just want to save some space. I don't see the need to have my clips in 2K resolution. And here, of course, you can include your webcam in the videos if you want. All right, video settings is done. As you saw, it's super simple to set up. And now the second most important part is the audio settings. So this is where, when I saw these options here, I absolutely started to love this software. The first two settings we have are recording computer and game audio and recording our microphone. So you probably want to leave both of these on. And here, this is big, especially for streamers. You can add literally as many inputs and outputs as you want. I can pretty much go on infinitely. I don't know what's the limit. I can't imagine anyone needing to find out what's the limit, but I love this option that you have so many input and output choices. Because the way I have it set it up is that I have my game audio and my Discord audio where I have a voice chat with my teammates separate. This means I can lower the gameplay volume a little bit more because it's not really that important most of the time, and leave my Discord chat a little bit higher so it's really easy to hear what my teammates are saying in the clip, because when you have it both on the same level, then in the clip you're recording, you might not even be able to hear your teammates. So if you can separate these inputs, then I highly recommend you do so. If you don't have this option, then just forget about what I just said. And also you can add as many microphones as you need obviously I just use one, so I'm gonna use one here. But if you want to use more microphones, I don't know why exactly, maybe some podcasts, then there's an option for this. We have advanced settings as well, which I don't recommend you touch at all. And the next one is hotkeys. And here we have just one really important keybind we have to change. If you find a bookmark or clip while recording, then I have it bound to F10. But of course, feel free to choose any keyboard button you want. This is the button where when you press that key on your keyboard, it will save the last X moments of your gameplay. If you remember, we talked about this option earlier in the video already. All right, so that's the only important thing you need to know about hotkeys. So next one, we have fancy features, and it sounds really exciting. So let's check it out, what's in it. So here, first thing first, if you play League of Legends or Valorant, then you can get automatic markings for kills, deaths, etc. So you just need to set your region and the software will do the rest for you. And here again, this is something we already talked about, but you can choose here if you want to record full-length videos of your game or only clips once you press your hotkey. As you can see, the interface is really elegant and easy to understand. There's literally everything you need, but nothing more, which I really love. The software doesn't give you any room to get confused. Everything is super simple, and you can just set everything up in 2 minutes and then forget about it. So all you now have to do is go play some games, get some sick highlights that you can clip, and then come back to the software and choose the clip you just got in your game. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose this one. And here you can rewatch your clip, you can fast forward if you want, which makes it super easy to check whether it was a good clip or not. And what's really cool about the software is, for example, I have 2 minutes of footage here, but I don't really need that much. I only want the last, let's say, 15 seconds where I get a sick headshot on this dude here. You can see it in a moment. Oh, there we go. I only want this clip. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna press make a clip and then cut it down to the last, let's say, 15 seconds. Let's see. Yep. And even more. Let's make it 10 so I can put it on my Instagram stories. And there we go. That's pretty much all I need. Create the clip. Title it if I want. Sick reacts. You can also add some tags so people can find it. There we go, save it. And now when we go back to the dashboard, we can see our clip appearing here in the recordings. And remember in the settings, we could choose the designated folder for our videos. That same clip we just cut shorter to 10 seconds is also in that folder as an MP4 file. So you can easily just upload it to YouTube, TikTok, Instagram, wherever, or send it to your friends, which is such an amazing feature. And now when we want to, we can also upload this clip to Lowkey so we can get a link which we can share with our friends. And so up here we can see that it's uploading. Now it's done. We can view it. This is where other people on Lowkey can also see this clip and comment on it and leave some reacts, I guess. And then with the share button, you can literally get a link and just share it to your friends. This is probably the easiest and quickest way I found to share your highlight clips with your friends. They also have some other options where you can share. The Discord button is meant to automatically upload it to your Discord server in a designated channel, like clips channel. But it doesn't work yet, but I've been told that they're actively working on it, and hopefully it will be working soon, because again, I think this is a really cool feature and I can't wait for this to go live. So here, if you just press on the chain, it says the link is copied and you can send it to your friend and he will instantly see the clip you just got like 2 minutes ago. When it comes to performance, so far I haven't noticed any issues with performance, but I do have a pretty high-end PC as well. So if you have a low-end PC, then definitely test it out yourself. But as far as I know, this software is not very FPS hungry, so it should be good. Again, the download link is in the description. Go check it out. I highly recommend this to everyone who is a gamer at heart, even if just a little bit, so you can share your proudest moments in gaming with your friends and family. That's it for me today. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. GG.